السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We're still in the first visit to Iraq distributing the Qurbani that has been slaughtered in the first day. As I mentioned before in my previous episode, actually, that we slaughtered more than 600 sheep in the mosque. And we divided our team. Aftab took the car with the carcasses to go to distribute in heat. وعانا وحديثة وراوة in the northwest on the north northwest, and I took the big truck to go north and south north to Samarra as well as Mosul and come back from Samarra and Mosul to Baghdad and go to the south to Karbala and Najaf and Kufa then Al Basra. I was having another car next to the big fridge with us, and Aftab went to his area and came back to Baghdad, and I carried on. The second day we started after Fajr to go to Samarra to distribute through the Awqaf municipality in the area through the mosques there, and then from there went to Al Mosul, which is called Nainawa. Also with coordination of the authority of the Awqaf in the area to distribute to the mosque, to the Musallin who come to the mosque and to benefit from this meat. And we prayed in the mosque of Sayyidina Yunus ibn Matta alayhi salam in Al-Mosul. That's why Mosul has another name called Nainawa. That was actually on the second day. On the third day, we came late, just before Fajr of the third day, and then we took the vehicle and the small car to go south, as I mentioned, to go to the Kufa, Najaf, Karbala, and we stayed overnight to distribute in this area through the Husayniyat. And the Sadana, or the in charge of serving the places, the holy places, of our companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is Imam Ali alayhi salam, Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, and Imam Muslim bin Aqil alayhi salam. And we stayed the night there to pray and to visit the three places in this area in the companionship with the people who are actually serving these holy places. Then on the fourth day of Eid, we went down south to Basra in a very hot situation, very hot atmosphere. And there also through our partner in Basra, which is the Awqaf municipality or the Awqaf authority, to distribute it through the mosque network. And when we finished the distribution, there was some part of this should be going to the prison and to other places as well. Before leaving Basra, we decided to visit the General Hospital of Basra, to see the general condition of the hospital, to see the needs of the hospital, see the needs of the patient, and to visit the doctors there. And to our astonishment, we found that the rate of discovering children with leukemia was on the rise, rocket high. Why? Because of the uranium depleted missiles being dropped into Basra, into Baghdad, into Kufa, into Najaf, into Karbala, into on Iraq. It was rocket high, and it was shocking, and nobody was talking about it because the alliance forces denied doing this. But the fact is that actually those people actually in Basra have the evidence, in Baghdad have the evidence, in Kufa and Karbala and Najaf have the evidence. And we decided to have another visit to Iraq later on to deal with this. I had about 250,000 Iraqi dinar to give. I said, let me give it to the doctors in the hospital to distribute it to the workers. And the doctor said, I cannot take it from you unless take the permission of the security in Basra. You know, 250,000 Iraqi dinar at that time was actually less than $300. What a humiliation to a very credible, dignified, rich people of Iraq who used to help everyone and anyone before this incident happened. Why should we be punishing the people of Iraq? Why should we be punishing the citizens of Iraq? Why should we be punishing the children of Iraq? one should be very proud of having more than 500,000 children dying, or nearly 1 million children dying because of the siege and because of leukemia in this area. And this was some of the leaders, the global or the international leaders, were actually very proud to humiliate the people of Iraq. And you know what the government of Iraq was saying at the time? You make the siege around Iraq, and this will never affect us as government, but this will affect the people of Iraq, and you are killing our people by not actually lifting this siege or embargo on Iraq. And this is how I felt the pain again. Dignity, integrity, credibility of those individuals. Those individuals whom the history of humanity were the best helper for others, whether in Europe, whether in the Middle East, whether everywhere. And we kept blind eye to them for years and years and years. And we decided to come back in the late summer to discuss the issue of leukemia as well. See you in the second episode.